The pathology now goes to the pathologist, and that pathologist will evaluate that tissue and come up with a diagnosis, whether there's cancer, whether there's no cancer, or whether there's some questionable areas that need a further evaluation. If there is prostate cancer, or even if there isn't prostate cancer, routinely that pathology and the length of time is routinely about anywhere between 3 to 5 working days, at least for us over at USMD. So I routinely see my patients back in about a week afterwards, or even when I do biopsies for my partners, and they go back in a week or so to chat with those, their physicians about this. It's important to realize that we run special stains. So it's not like you just take the pathology and you look under the microscope and you see cancer or no cancer. Several times we actually run special stains to evaluate whether this is a specific type of cancer. So it does take a fair amount of time, you know, certainly several working days to actually evaluate whether there's cancer located in there. But routinely, we'll see those patients back in a week, and then we go over the results with them. And I think this is particularly important for these patients for two reasons. Number one, if we find cancer, it's very important to go over in detail the grade of the cancer, where the cancer is located, and sort of the next steps of where we need to go from there. I would argue that it's equally important to talk to those patients when we don't find prostate cancer. And why is that? Well, because you have to look statistically. Statistically speaking, there is a chance that we, even though we did a prostate biopsy, that there may be cancer and we just didn't biopsy that particular area. And I try to explain to people about the needle in the haystack. So if you've got a big haystack, even though we know that that prostate cancer tends to be on the outsides of that haystack, there is a chance that we didn't find that prostate cancer, you know, again, in that needle in the haystack. So what I tell patients is that when they come back, and we see them back and we don't see any focus of prostate cancer, I say, great news, there's no cancer. However, we still want to follow you pretty closely, because if you are one of those small percentage of patients that could still have a focus of cancer that was not originally biopsied, we hope that it will declare itself in the ensuing future, meaning the next 6 months, 12 months, 18 months. And routinely, I recommend a repeat PSA. I recommend a total and free PSA at that point to make sure that it gives us more information about that PSA to let us know, is could this be a patient that, again, may require a repeat biopsy in the near future for that particular patient. Again, if that total PSA increases. So for an example, let's say a patient comes in and his PSA is 4.5. We do a prostate biopsy on him. It's negative. Great news. Everybody's happy. I see him back in 6 months and his PSA is still 4.5, but his percent free, and again, that's a component of the total PSA, is low, meaning it's about 11%. Anything below 12 to 15% means that there's an increased risk that there could be a focus of cancer there. So if I see that there's a low percent free PSA, at that point we have to have the discussion about, could we have missed something in that original biopsy? And then we'd have that discussion about whether there are further evaluations we need to do for that patient, whether we need to consider a repeat biopsy. On the flip side of it, he comes back and his PSA is, maybe it's gone down to 3.7, and his percent free PSA is, let's say, in that sort of gray range in the, you know, high teens, or let's say 23%, and he's doing great. And we say, you know what, good news, we're not seeing any significant changes, and we continue to follow that patient expectantly.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed. But right now, a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment, or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.